what's your history with the workshop, and how did you first come into contact with the company?
I think that I started you guys stuff around that same time, probably it was 1990, I started just sending you guys random stuff in the mail.
What was the inspiration for the Kill Trend Continuum deck paintings that you did for the workshop? The Cocoa one, which features fruit bats and Lassie with a hand in her mouth.
Well, and I did John's first, but look, we can talk about Cocoa. I had the photo of Cocoa, which is my daughter, and I was just stoked on how she was just standing there, you know, kind of like a, you know, very proper and kind of posing like a model with her little blanket in her hand. And from the picture I had, she was, you know, nice and long and tall. And I go, well, you know what? I want to paint her anyway. And I know that she would be stoked and on it for sure. But maybe it would inspire her to do more art. She loves to paint. She wants to paint all the time. And she looks at the picture now and she's like, oh, that's me. Beautiful Coco. I've never painted bats before. So I think they turned out really, really good. Lassie, Coco's kind of afraid of dogs. At least big dogs. So, and we don't have a dog, but she always sees that. She's like, oh, get the dog away, you know. And so I kind of wanted to, you know, I don't want her to be afraid of dogs. So I kind of painted the Lassie as a big dog, but it's always been, you know, kind of a nice dog. Lassie's perfect. It's like he fetched this hand. You know, Coco's playing catch with his hand with a razor blade.
Having seen it myself, it was really well done. Okay, and then the John Pryor deck, and I guess you must know him.
I never met him personally, but my friend Hunter, who's a Nike team manager, he grew up skating with him in San Jose, so I just hear stories about John Pryor, so I go, John would be perfect. I don't even know if he knows that if the boards are coming out. You know, I don't think Hunter was going to tell him, and they might just show up at the shop. You know, there's some filler, some horses, and a bear down the bottom, and kind of just like the background artwork. It really doesn't have anything to do with John. Just, you know, I'm just kind of stick on the animal tip, and, you know, just painting animals. I've been doing that lately in all my paintings. Yeah, it's totally random. The main focus was just supposed to be John, and I painted him on, my grandma used to paint a ton on pieces of wood, like trees that they cut in slivers, and she used to paint animals on those and give it to us for Christmas presents and birthday presents. That's what the only thing she gave. Okay, I would get an antelope, and my brother would get a cheetah, kind of just, I liked the idea of painting on wood, so I kind of wanted to emulate that for John's picture.
And when did you first come to realization that you were an artist?
The term artist, kind of a strange term for me, you know, but I guess I do art. You know, I don't make a living doing that, but I enjoy painting a ton. It gives me, you know, pleasure and, you know, time away and you know, do something different.
I just want to say thanks on behalf of myself and the whole company. The contribution you made for the decks.
Thank you too for, you know, giving me, you know, product over the years and helping me skateboard and just, you know, be doing stuff, like I said, different than your normal companies out there.